Hello and welcome back to the Let's Play Skyrim. I was going to sleep for a couple of hours to let the rain pass. However, when I do that, hired thugs are standing around my bed when I wake up. They're a little tough at this level. So, I think a nice walk in the rain will be safer for me. And there goes the rain anyway. Yeah, those are the thugs. Luckily, they move very slowly. Oh, fuck. Totally missed that. Oh, crap. And discover this location. I don't think I'm gonna go in there, but it's nice to have it discovered. Okay. Let's see if we can avoid that cat.
I've been looking for you. Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only.
Interesting.
Let's see here. Ah, a letter from the Jarl. Moving up in the world, eh? Looks like that's it.
You say so. Still would like to know how he heard me. Finally back at White Run. Let's go sell some stuff. One bad thing about the autosave when it happens unexpectedly. So there's a brief stutter.
Got some good pieces out here if you're looking to buy. More inside. Looking to protect yourself or deal some damage?
Looking to sell some stuff. Well, let's see, what do we have? Oh, that's right, most of the stuff I had to sell is actually going to be on Inigo. Sell that though. Doesn't sell that.
Don't forget to check inside the shop if you need anything.
This town is very pretty, but it is not as delightfully damp as Riften. Lee Wright, what are we trading?
Oh, let's see. A lot of things. All of those. Most of those. Which I'll take a lot. You can keep that actually.
I don't claim to be the blades, helmets, pretty much anything to suit your needs.
All right. That should do that.
Thanks for the business.
No problem.
Watch what you're doing.
Let's go see Bellathor.
Welcome, Bellathor's general goods. Welcome indeed. Everything's for... Oh, a bit of this and a bit of that.
All right, what do we got? In there. Okay. I really need to find some place to store the ingredients and the books. Start holding on to the gems for now, though. Not really need money at the moment. All right.
Do come back.
Realized that I never actually investigated Hogan for the Live Another Life thing, so I'm gonna head back in that direction and do that. Let's just double check that I've got everything set up as a favorite. Warpig. Shield, bow, healing. Okay. All good. Just wait for my stamina to come back. Just in case there's any surprises waiting for me outside the door. And let's see. Like they've caught up with it yet, so.
We are exposed here, but it is beautiful.
Gotta agree. It's a bit odd to see wildlife so close to town. Tempted to buy a horse, since I've actually got some money. Oh. I don't have time. I'll just figure out if I can remember what that location is. It's pointing there, but maybe something new. We have wolves. I'm not going to be chasing him down. Back to Riverwood at last. Wait, did I? Not what I wanted to do, I wanted to journal. Yeah, I forgot to collect the bounty. But that would have required going to Dragon's Reach and trying to avoid that at the moment. On top. Have any friends? Oh, wait. I'm just going to take the pelt and the. And the ingredients. I don't really need the meat. So many locations in this direction. It's Looks like one's fairly close down here. Oh, the camp down there. Okay. Fair enough. Let's go and discover. Fishing camp.
Watch what you're doing.
What? Oh, did I kick your fishing pole? Alright. Nothing really of value down here. Thought I collected that. Must have missed it. Or it respawned. One or the other. Yeah, I don't
your
think
I... Your homeland is a feast for the eyes.
Thank you. I don't think I, killed the bandits that were over here. It's hard to remember because I died several times and I don't
this
remember which playthrough I did which on.
Magnificent.
Nope, I did not. Hi, guys.
It's a bad time to get lost.
Oh, yeah. Whoops. Take that. Alright, I think I got everything. I'm gonna collect some more leather, make some bandoliers and pouches. Tree bark and animal fat to make leather. Okay. What's this location over here as I get sidetracked? Oh, is this that place with the skeletons? Okay. Let's do that too. But first, that's not what I want to do. That's what I want to do. Delayed sound effect. Finish getting up first.
This air is pure and clean.
Inigo?
My friend, Skyrim is a big and often confusing place. We are bound to lose each other from time to time.
Okay,
never fear. That map you have is special. Let me show you. My brother once found one just like it on the remains of some poor old adventurer in Citadel. It does not only mark locations, it can also show the position of items and people too. Watch this. Where are you, Inigo? There! See? I have placed myself on your map. If we find ourselves separated, all you need to do is look me up. Pretty fantastic, eh?
That's actually kind of useful.
No problem. I am always happy to help.
In the meantime,
I will bear your burdens gladly.
That's good. Because I have a lot for you to carry. Actually, you could probably wear that if you wanted to. You like light armor? Too much of my weight. Let's see, what else do I carry in this head? Alright, I can carry a bit more now.
If you need anything else, just ask.
Whoa! I hate doing that. Okay. Let's go ahead and save. Evening. You imperialist bastards. Here to get back to the road. There we go. Is that the camp I started at? I think so. There's the cave. I'm gonna skip grabbing the adventurer's journal. Getting a bit hungry. Oh, and I need to level up. Let's see, food first. Stuff's starting to go stale. That's still good though. And also, let's level up. haven't put anything into stamina for a while. Let's do that. It's 60 before that becomes useful. Don't really do too much jumping off of high spots in armor, so it doesn't really matter that much. I need 30 for that. That's a nice one. What's this one? That's definitely the one I need next. Any other skills I need points in? Because being an archery or alchemy. Actually, no, I don't do it enough. This is mostly just to top up after a combat. So. I can do some smithing, or I could just. Oh, I got 3 points. I haven't spent points in a while. This is a tough choice, actually. Let's go with Imperial. Once again, I realize I've been walking around with my light on the entire time. It's a bad habit to get into if, what is that noise? I don't want to talk to you. But Sometimes I forget how nasty poison can be. How long is this poison going to last? Or is it poison? Or have I got some kind of bleeding effect? This is probably where one of those poultices would have come in handy. Here we go. What have I told you about getting in my way? No idea what causes that. It's very annoying. Again, I wasn't even pushing any buttons in. It just happened. That was a bad place for an autosave, though. Okay, apparently I need to tough this out for another 2.5 minutes. Of course I don't have any Magicka versions on me. Mostly because I sell them. mental note, I need to craft some poultices. Luckily, I have a crap ton of these minor healing potions. This is a good way to work up restoration experience. I think it's done now. Okay, still have head trauma, but it's not bleeding anymore. So we can move on now. I didn't want to come back down here because sometimes just traveling down here causes these spiders to spawn. Ow! Didn't I go play with the spiders? Have fun? Oh, the hired thug. Oh, crap. Here we go again. go ahead and pause the recording. I'll pick it up again once I've gotten rid of this trauma. Alright, we're back. I've gotten rid of the bleeding. I killed the spiders that were that respawned. Well, not respawned, but the ones that were triggered when we came back down the passage. I even extracted their venom because frostbite venom is actually pretty decent. Lasts a while and the target is paralyzed for 2 seconds. Any kind of paralysis is very nice. But since we're likely to be attacked by hired thugs on the other side, I think I should use a poison on my weapon. I'm just trying to decide which poison. Could use the frostbite. Like I said, the paralysis is pretty useful. Or there's frenzy. Because it's only up to level 5, so these are probably higher level than that. This does a crap ton of damage. I think this is what I'll go with. But I want to favorite the frostbite venom. And this one too. Alright. One more quick save before we head out. Once again, like I did the first time, when it happens, I'm going to try and move to the right and get behind them.
There he goes. Looks like he's gone for good this time.
Okay.
I'll wait to know if anyone else made it out alive.
All that preparation for nothing.
Swarming with Imperials soon enough. Should clear out of here. My sister, Gerda, runs the mill in Riverwood, just up the road. I'm sure she'd help you out. Probably best if we split up.
Yeah. I think I'm gonna go to sleep where I started the game. Let's look at
this that night, Predator's Delight.
Oh, apparently I can't sleep while I'm injured. To be ready for anything. Did I make one of those poultices? Okay, I can make it out of garlic and wheat. Or I can make it out of potion of healing. Or a potion of minor healing. Let's do one of the minor healing ones. Let's make a couple of extra ones. How much longer is this trauma going to last? Apparently I don't have the trauma anymore. Did it just fade or... Apparently it just faded. Alright, let's sleep until morning. Feels like it's been a long day. Ah crap, I'm gonna get attacked by damn bandits when I get, or thugs when I get up. I just realized it. No? Not looking to get a horse in the mouth. I was really expecting to be surrounded when I woke up.
Mr. Dragonfly is having a good time at the moment. He enjoys traveling with us very much.
That's good. I'm gonna head to Riverwood. Might even look at the bounty board and or bounty board. The notice board. Good job, guys. It's not an axe, but this is a lot better armor than it used to be. Let's move on before.
I was wondering, can you whistle?
Yeah.
Well, it could be a good way for us to quickly... It made interesting reading. Maybe you should give it a look over. Anyway, what did you want to talk about?
Wanted...
They say that dragons have returned to Skyrim. The Helgen attack does not bode well. I wonder if the Jarl of Whiterun knows he has a giant lizard problem. If not, he may reward us for the information.
You have a valid point. But we're not going to tell him just yet.
I hope you are right. A lot of people may be in danger. I am here
in the meantime.
You give me best equipment, yes?
You could probably use some of this, actually. Let's see. Oh wait, I'm taking this stuff. Crap. I gotta pay attention to what I'm doing. My way down. 349. All right, let's get enough.
What's next?
Lunch. Something close enough for me to investigate. You don't look like you're going to be too happy to see me. You have a lot of friends.
Well met, traveler. Do you come to watch the Dance of Bones, to pay homage, or to learn the craft? It is not I who you should be conversing with. Look upon this piece, and it will speak to you. What you see before you is art in its purest form, unbound by the conventions of society, free to show the naked truth. Well said, traveler. I didn't expect to meet an artist of your caliber here in the wilderness. Appreciation takes many forms. The most spiteful criticism is usually reserved for the most thought-provoking of art. So, I take their criticisms as a compliment. The more people view an art piece, the more interpretations are derived from it. Like a flower to the sun, the art flourishes when the light of the people is cast upon it. I'm more than willing to die for my art. Still, I have made some compromises to protect myself. Using skeletons in place of living bodies is one example. Necromancer? I'll forgive your crude mistake. After all, many fail to see the beauty in that which is soiled. I do not practice the art of necromancy. I practice necromantic art. The distinction is rather important. I trained at the College of Winterhold, where necromancy is legal and accepted, but only for research and study. My views regarding the artistic potential of the undead were not readily embraced. The parting was mutual, but I'll say this. Contrary to what some may tell you, I have no interest in using the dead as a weapon. If we truly wish to understand the nature of our existence, we must bring death to life and life to death, so the two may define the void between. Only the presence of my colleagues, so many brilliant minds, each a treasure trove of the profound. Some, like Master Gester, would challenge your mind with hypotheticals. Questions that have no answer. Very well. Consider the following. In your travels, you come across a man living in an abandoned house. There is evidence that he is a deplorable man. A murderer. A rapist. A thief. However, he is also a brilliant alchemist. He is on the verge of a breakthrough potion that will cure any disease. This is important, as a new plague is spreading across the land. However, if the man is allowed to sell the potion, he will become very powerful and very rich. Many will suffer at his hand. What do you do? Give me an answer, traveler, and learn more about yourself.
My fur feels charged.
Yet the sum of death is far greater than the pain of his victims. You value the sapling in the ground as the forest burns around you. Foolish, perhaps, and yet something to be admired. I use the tools of conjuration to make art pieces that reflect the human condition, the struggles of man, his joy, his sadness, his frailty. His clothes are stripped, his bones bared for all to see. Yet even an artist cannot fully understand a work through a single set of eyes. Tell me, stranger, how does this piece make you feel? Like most, you fail to consider whether the undead are people. Your instincts tell you they are an imminent threat. My skeletons, however, are docile. Innocents. Brothers in arms, childhood friends, husband and wife. They were once these things. But what are they now? What determines whether one is living or dead? Is it? Can a soul exist on its own? The black soul gem fragments on this altar once contained a human soul. If that is the true essence of man, should that not be more offensive than the skeletons?
Alright, fair enough.
What do you do? Give me an answer, Trevor, and learn more about yourself.
I've already answered this, but let's pick a different answer to get a different outcome.
Can you stand by and watch as his perversion and power increases? At least if you were to leave and leave, you would be spared of the harm.
Alright. Well, I'm doing nothing but getting wet here, so moving on. Come along, Indigo. Let's find somewhere to dry off. Did I miss the turn somewhere? Back on track. And all. Let's check out the apothecary. Borrow the alchemy table. Then I think I'll head in, head to the inn and get out of the rain for a while. What do we have here? Let's do some restore health first.
If you're not going to drink all that wine, maybe you should sell it out.
Have for damage health. Clear selection.
I bet you could get a good price for those gems.
Still only 5%. No, but
everything you see here.
Salmon. That's weird. Okay. That shouldn't be too hard. I could get quite a few of them right here in Riverwood.
Welcome. Let me know if you want anything. I think I got a clean mug around here somewhere.
What do I have for food? It's mildly stale. I don't remember what the penalties are for mildly stale. Or stale, for that matter. I'll risk it. Well, no penalties at the moment, so... Excuse me. Kind of late here. I think it's a good sign, and I need to get to bed too. So. What time is it? It is only 1 in the afternoon in game. So. Gonna save the game here. Thank you for joining me. I will see you next time.